good day to all. My name is Raghuraman. I'm so happy to be here with all of you. I'm the co-author of Sales Shastra. My co-author Tanmay is here, and Vigneshwar, it's so nice to meet you. To give a quick update about myself, I've been a sales and marketing veteran, more than 25 years of work experience. We'll be completing actually 30 years of work experience this August, and predominantly in sales and marketing. And after working for about two decades in various sales roles, you know, started as a front-end salesperson, then to management, grew up the cadre. About 9 years back, I quit and started my own sales training company called Sales Art, with a Z in the middle. So it's basically art of selling and science of selling. So we train a lot of retail and corporate sales people. And me and Tanmay were ex-colleagues in one of the companies that we worked before. And that's how we have continued to be in touch. So I will talk more about this relationship a little later.
Yeah.
So over to you, Tanmay.
Hey, thanks, Raghu, and thanks, Vigneshwara, for you know, giving us this opportunity to talk to you. So my name is Tanmay. I'm an author. I'm an IT professional. This is my sixth book, you know, technically speaking. I have written three fiction books, and this is my third non-fiction book. So yeah, that's what pretty much I do. I also, what I do is, as a hobby, that I also coach people to write books. So I'm also a book writing coach. So that's what you know, I do: author, book writing coach, IT professional, about 20 years of sales and marketing experience.
That's great. So thank you for your introductions as well, Tanmay, as well as Raghuraman sir. Today I would like to idea, how did you come about you know, writing this book or co-authoring this book? Where did the idea come from in Sales Shastra?
You know, as a salesperson, you know, I'm a salesperson, Tanmay is a salesperson. You know, we might have grown in our careers, become managers or business managers and all that, but the bottom line is we have to keep selling.
Yeah.
You know, हर महीने का टारगेट है, हर क्वार्टर का टारगेट है. यू हैव टू कीप अचीविंग टारगेट्स, नंबर्स. यू हैव टू गेट पीपल अराउंड यू टू अचीव देयर नंबर्स. सो सेल्स इज लाइक पार्ट ऑफ अस. एंड व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड माय दैट्स आई एम वेरी पैशनेट अबाउट ग्रूमिंग सेल्स पीपल. एंड व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड द ट्रेनिंग कंपनी सेल्स आर्ट, यू नो, आई एम ट्रेनिंग सेल्स रेप्स ऑफ वेरियस क्लाइंट्स. एंड वन ऑफ द थिंग्स, एज आई वाज डूइंग दिस, you know, I realized, why can't we have all these learnings that I have over the years, you know, why can't we communicate it in a very simple form to people who are getting into sales profession, or those who have started their journey in sales career, but they are not having the same benefits that I had when I started my career. Where when companies used to take 3 months, 6 months, they would train people whom they hired as management trainees or sales trainees. Whereas, you know, post 2008, you know, the recession and slowdown, companies just want employees who join and start working from day one.
Yeah.
You know, that whole concept of training a person, putting the person through, pehle 3-6 months tu sirf seekh le. There's no pressure on numbers on you. You know, you just learn how to do things. You know, that part is kind of gone. Yeah. A lot of companies, it's like a fish thrown into water. And I realized, why can't we create a simple common code? You know, something that salespeople can easily learn, read, self-read, understand, or managers can use it as a training book for their people. And it is also a way of giving back to the profession, which has made me what I am today. Okay. You know, so that's how I started codifying this as DNAs.
Yeah.
DNA of a champion salesperson. That's how we
that
started
was
codifying it.
That was your English version of
that is the English version. But as I'm doing this over a few years, you know, I'm not a writer, you know, I'm a trainer.
Yeah.
You know, I can train people. So I'm codifying this. Then I met Tanmay. You know, we keep meeting on and off, you know, ex-colleagues and all that. And he's, by the time he started publishing his books, fiction books, thriller, you know, a couple of books he had already published, and we were talking. And that's when we thought, why don't we combine forces? Mm-hmm. You know, you have the idea, you have the creative, you have these DNAs. And so here I come with this contribution, and then Tanmay has, you know, the, as he himself said, you know, he's helping people write books, you know. So he's now become a post this experience. He actually has become a writing coach. So we said, why don't we combine the strengths of both of us?
Yeah.
And Tanmay also comes with sales experience. So he's also very passionate about these. So we started kind of like sparring partners in boxing, you know. These are the DNAs and fine tuning it, putting it together. And that's how the book got formed, you know. So we said we will write this book both in English and Hindi.
Yeah.
And we wanted to, we launched English, and we immediately wanted to launch the Hindi version, Sales Shastra, but it took that little extra time to get the right kind of language, the English.
Yeah, mix. I remember as you,
and then
as
the
you
pandemic
saying,
happened.
Yes, I remember you saying that for Hindi, I'll need Tanmay's help. For Hindi,
So that's how we, and finally here we are today. Our dream is now a reality.
Yeah.
So Tanmay, you want to add anything?
Yeah, his video was off, so I was wondering, has he left?
Yeah, no. I'm still there. So I think Raghu has pretty much summed it, what I said. I think, what I would like to cover is the I would say actual hardships that we've gone through while writing a Hindi version. So शुरू में हमें ऐसा लगा कि बहुत आसान है, English में तो लिखा है और you just have to हिंदी में लिख देंगे, उसमें क्या बड़ी बात है, you know, anything like that. Mm-hmm. But then we realized the approach of writing both the books is very, very different.
Very different.
And plus, what has happened is the today's reader, वो यद्यपि किंतु परंतु इस तरह के शब्दों का वो लोग
use
नहीं करते,
use
नहीं करते. So we consciously took a choice कि यार हम इसमें English words, because ये management की word है बहुत सारे. अब जैसे अगर कोई word है product manager, product manager को आप हिंदी में करोगे उत्पाद प्रबंधक, ये बिल्कुल resonate नहीं करेगा किसी.
Exactly.
Right, a product manager is a product manager. तो हमने जानबूझ के conscious decision लिया कि यार हम इसमें English words को as it is रहने देंगे. और जैसे और आजकल हम लोग कई लोग जैसे सॉरी को हम सॉरी बोलते हैं, इट हैज बिकम पार्ट ऑफ हिंदी नाउ, दिस काइंड ऑफ वर्ड कि सॉरी है,
कोटेशन, क्षमा, तुम्हारा कोटेशन भेजना,
करेक्ट, हाँ तुम अपना कोटेशन भेज दो, या कृपया कर मुझे क्षमा कर दीजिए, इस तरह के वर्ड हम लोग यूज नहीं करते. आई एम सॉरी फॉर. एग्जैक्टली. सो एज राइटर्स, व्हेन यू स्टार्ट राइटिंग इन अ लैंग्वेज, यू हैव टू बी यू नो रिस्पेक्ट, यू शुड पे रिस्पेक्ट टू द लैंग्वेज ऑल्सो. That you just cannot write the way you want to do it. So that was a very tricky part. कि हम लोगों को इसको book को relevant भी बनाना था कि लोग पढ़े भी. Mm-hmm. इतना ज़्यादा academic book ना हो जाए कि जिसको देख के लोग बोले यार ये क्या है, you know, this is not doing good and all that. So that was, I think, that took us time. Mm-hmm. जो रघु कह रहे थे कि you know this will it took us time and all that. So we went through multiple drafts, multiple versions. Or both me and Raghu spent time, and we realized the enormity of the task. So it was as good as writing a new book.
New book.
So it was as good as writing a new book.
During this process of writing, even the first book, the English version, and now the Hindi version, during this whole process, were there differing opinions and clashes between y'all?
Not really.
I would put it more than clashes, more of sparring.
Yeah.
See, one of the, as I said, when 1+1 many times is more than 2. See, for example, there are times when you have to give a much more simpler example. Mm-hmm. To get the point across.
Yes.
You know, So that's where, you know, we would debate examples. No, this is a better example. No, this is a better example. Yeah. You know, what to give, you know, and sometimes use of words like what Tanmay said. Originally, we wanted to keep it Shuddh Hindi, and both of us were debating it out for almost 2 months. No, then we realized that you cannot have it. In fact, we have even written a small apology in our beginning of the book.
Disclaimer.
To the language, to people who will get language, offended purist. That we are not using pure Hindi. That guys, this is being targeted at sales people. Jo apna career sales mein shuru kar raha hai, people who are in shops, who are dealing with customers. And you know, customers will use mix of English. Quotation bhej do. Tumhara product theek nahi hai. Best price batao.
Yeah.
Batao deal aaj pakke karte hai. You know, that kind of. So it has to be mix of Hindi and English, but relevant. So we had a lot of these kind of to and fro's till we. Then we would go to third party market and sort out whether whose point was. And then we arrived at a. Okay, let's move ahead with this.
Then you finally made this book happen through that sparring and debates and all that, and finally the book.
Absolutely. And thanks to Ajay, Ajay, finally making that dream into reality. Because you need somebody also to be there in the journey, right?
Exactly, to back up
and not lose patience.
But how did you guys meet? You and Tanmay, how did you guys meet, and how, like, you told me how you started co-authoring?
We were working in a company together. Raghu was my senior, and I learned a lot of things from Raghu. So I always had this respect towards him as a person, as somebody who's senior and who knows his craft very well. So I always had this thing with him. So. And as Raghu said, when he left and he started his own company, I was quite keen to, and I was very excited to see what he's doing, because what he did 10 years ago was quite unthinkable. He was at a very leadership position, and to just leave that position in a comfortable, cushy job to start something like a sales training on their own was a very, very courageous step to take at that point of time. So I was always very much inspired by what he was doing. So we kept in touch, and to answer to your point, that I met him in one of the companies which we were working, and we spent a good time together, and hence, maybe that's the reason we were almost in the same wavelength when it came to writing and crafting and putting things together.
So what have you guys, through this whole experience, co-authoring a book, and as you said, he told me how your experience was as well as yours, Tanmay. How did this process of making a book come to reality, how was that process impacted you, and what have you took away from this as an experience?
As a book writing coach, as a writer, what happens when you work in a product or a project individually, you approach it in a different manner when you're carrying the entire burden in your shoulder. Now, when you co-author a product or a project, you have to let go a lot of things, and you have to be more open, and you have to divide and conquer, and you have to use, as Raghu said, these both strengths. You have to leverage both the strengths. So while Raghu was great creating in content, my job was how can I fix it all together using my creativity. So So co-authoring, my take here would be that other than focusing on the difference of opinion and other stuff, we should leverage each other's strength, and to make our job simpler, easier, and to the best of best whatever offer you can do. So you're here creating a great product, great book, something of real value. So that is achieved very well when you work in a shared environment.
Absolutely.
And helping each other.
In fact, just to add to what Tanmay is saying, my biggest learning, Vigneshwar, is this, which I want to, I keep communicating to everybody, and through this interaction also, I hope it gets communicated far and wide, is you have this knowledge within you. You have this dream. A lot of experienced people want to give it back to the world. They want to write a book, they want to do it, but for some reason or the other, things keep getting postponed, procrastinated. They will write 10 pages, 20 pages, 30 pages, and then they give away.
And then they face a roadblock or something, and you know.
Yeah, something like that. My suggestion to all of them would be two things. One, doesn't matter if it takes time. For example, when we launched DNA a couple of years back, that itself was a couple of years late, you know, because, but then it happened. Similarly, Hindi, we wanted to launch immediately. Sales Shastra, it took another one extra year, but it happened. See, sometimes we try to put artificial goals, and if you can't meet that goal, we give it up. So my request is, don't take an artificial goal. Keep doing it to completion. Instead of 2 years, let it take 5 years. But get it out there. You will have somebody like Invincible Ajay supporting you. You will find, they say Om Shanti Om mein bolta hai na, that dialogue, famous dialogue, that Sachche Dil Se you are trying something.
Then so
even God will, yeah, God will have to help you. That's exactly what happened to us. And the second thing I want to say is, don't, a lot of people are too possessive about their ideas. You know, and they want 100% credit for themselves. Mm-hmm. What is important is getting the thing out. What is your dream? To live and go with the idea or to get the book out? See, like what Tanmay said, you collaborate each other. He wanted to write non-fiction.
Yeah.
But he didn't progress. He was on fiction route only. I wanted to complete this book. I didn't progress. But see, together, we could make this happen. Mm-hmm. So, you know, both our goals got achieved, right?
Yeah.
So these are the two things that I would like to let people just take away. One, collaboration is good. If you can collaborate with somebody and that can help your dreams get realized, please do it. And second, don't put an artificial deadline. Ho jayega. If you keep at it, it'll happen. You know, like the guy who put this road or bridge in Bihar, you know, he took, there was a movie also on it, right?
I have no idea. I don't remember.
Manji.
But
yeah,
you know,
he created a road in a mountain.
Okay.
On his own, it took years and years, but he did it.
Slowly and steadily.
Exactly. Just don't give up. Keep doing it.
It's like the tortoise story, maybe just without the bunny. You know, slow and steady wins the race. Like, just slow, be consistent. Take whatever time you want, be consistent, basically.
Exactly. See, there is no limit, right? It is not like 26 years ho gaya, now I can't write UPSC. I've crossed this particular age, so I can't do that. Here, there is nothing like that.
Yeah.
I have seen people who have become Instagram blogger celebrities at the age of 65. It's most of the time, these artificial deadlines are what we put to ourselves.
Tanmay, as you're a non-fiction writer, mostly you write fantasy fiction and all this. So how was your experience when co-authoring a self-help book as such?
See, again, I'm coming from a coach perspective that, you know, what you need to do. See, while doing a non-fiction book, the only thing that you need to concentrate is upon the value and the problems that you're solving in the to whom you are doing it, right? Whereas in a fantasy or in a fiction, you'll still have a lot of I would say room to play around, where to go, and you can do that. So, but in a fiction book, in a non-fiction book, you have to kind of stick to the fact, reality, and ensure that the value that you're delivering through your book remains intact, because people are not going to read this book because they want to enjoy a pastime or anything like that. There's a specific problem that you're addressing through your book, that you're failing in sales, and here's a book that you read it and you will become super successful. So, and that's the reason we deliberately made it in Hindi also. Ki agar aap sales ko bahut kathin samajhte ho aur maal bechne mein aapko problem ho rahi hai, तो आप ये किताब पढ़ें और ये आपको इस तरीके से हेल्प कर सकती है. और उसको हमने एक सिलसिलेवार तरीके से उसको स्टेप्स में बांटा कि यार ये स्टेप्स हो सकते हो, ऐसे आप कर सकते हो. सो दिस इज व्हाट आई वुड लाइक टू से दैट यू नो यू नीड टू मे बी स्टिक टू द वैल्यू दैट यू आर डिलीवरिंग.
In fact, we even kept in mind that tomorrow an university could actually kind of empanel this book as a textbook.
Yeah.
So we have catered to both. Somebody who wants to read on his own time, get motivated. For example, the way we have structured it is every chapter has a story, a real life story basis our experience that a salesperson faces. And we end the chapter with और क्या हो सकता था या व्हाट कुड हैव दैट पर्सन डन, अब इस सिचुएशन में उसको क्या करना चाहिए था. एंड देन वी गेट इनटू थ्योरी, द एक्चुअल प्रॉब्लम्स, आंसर टू द प्रॉब्लम, वी गिव अ डिटेल एंड देन वी गिव टेम्पलेट्स एंड एक्सरसाइजेस फॉर पीपल टू प्रैक्टिस और अ मैनेजर टू यूज इट फॉर हिज टीम और अ ओनर टू यूज इट फॉर हिज एक्सटेंडेड टीम्स और डीलर्स और हूएवर. सो लाइक दिस वी हैव क्रिएटेड द होल थिंग. सो इट इज one, it gives you real life examples, so it is not only theory baji, it gives real life examples proper. We have given some 13 to 14 real life examples for each situation. So none of it is imaginary, they are all real life examples of what a salesperson would have faced, and then how to solve it, and then the actual theory about that whole subject. And then you have templates that you can use in real life and exercises you can use in real life. We hope some university actually kind of I wanted to add here. If you look at MBA curriculum in India, or anywhere, there is so much emphasis on marketing, customer communications, market research, consumer behavior. Very few people get into in-depth in sales. It gets lost in one of the four P's of marketing, place ke andar, it gets lost. As one of the things you do is, you know, price, product, you know, people get into the four P's, and in one of the P's, placement, distribution and sales also. Now, whereas sales is a very big thing touching millions of people in India, millions of people make their living as a salesperson. You know, somebody who's selling, your dealer selling books, or an insurance guy. We meet salespeople, right, in every store, every shop. Corporate sales, retail sales, everything is all about selling.
Yeah.
So we thought there is a gap here, there is a vacuum. In fact, MBA colleges, universities can actually use this book as a sales book. It kind of complements their curriculum.
So thank you for your wonderful time today. And I learned a lot as well about your book, Sales Shastra, which is going to be released soon. It's already there on Kindle. As an end note, would you like to tell our viewers something, Mr. Raghuram, as well as Mr. Zubair?
See, my take here is, humne isko Hindi mein bahut hi conscious decision ke liye liya hai, because ek Hindi mein kitabe bilkul nahi aa rahi hai aur achhi kitabe to aur bhi nahi aa rahi hai. और स्पेशली हमारी जो किताब है, जैसे रघु ने कहा, एक बहुत ही बड़े सेगमेंट को जिसको नज़रअंदाज किया गया है कि यार सेल्स तो कोई भी कर लेगा, यू नो, दुकान पे बैठ जाओ, माल कोई भी बेच लेगा. तो इसको, इस प्रॉब्लम को इतनी स्ट्रक्चरली हमने समझाया है इस किताब में बहुत ईजी तरीके से, और दैट्स द रीज़न दैट हमने उसको हिंदी में लिखा है कि भाई सभी लोग पढ़ें इसको. एंड इनविंसिबल पब्लिशर्स हैज बैक्ड आवर विजन. So our you know, the whole thing is that if it can reach to every nook and corner of the country, and if every salesperson, everybody who's into sales can get value out of it, aur agar usko wo improve karke apne munafe ko, apni companies ko aur better bana sakte hain, I think wahi hamara you know, chahat hai aur wahi hamara desire hai is book ke.
Great,
very very well
summarized,
Tanmay. Same पॉइंट आई एम एकोइंग. सेल्स एक बहुत बढ़िया प्रोफेशन है. आई विल रिकमेंड लॉट ऑफ इंडियन यंगस्टर्स टू गेट इन टू सेल्स. यू आर गोइंग टू बी मीटिंग पीपल, कम्युनिकेटिंग, प्रोडक्ट सर्विस सोल्यूशन बेच रहे हो कस्टमर को, यू आर गिविंग दम बेनिफिट्स एंड रिटर्न यू आर टेकिंग मनी फॉर योर कंपनी जिनके लिए भी आप बेच रहे हो. सो दिस बुक विल डेफिनेटली हेल्प यू डू बेटर इन योर लाइफ एंड बिजनेस.
It was a pleasure having you, Tanmay, as well as Raghuraman. Today, it was like I learned a lot about your book, about you as well as people. And it was a pleasure talking to you for this few minutes.
Thank you so much.
No problem.
Thank you.
All the best. Stay safe.
Thanks, Raghu. Thanks, Vignesh.
Bye.
Bye bye.
Thank you. Bye.